William Kunstler in the film William Kunstler, Disturbing the Universe. You now do your Q&As after the film this weekend, Cinema Village, with Yusuf Salam. Mm-hmm. Your thoughts now?
You know, that's been one of the great gifts of making this film. It's given us the opportunity to reconnect with Yusuf. You know, we doubted Yusuf's innocence back when we were children. So to be able to share this experience with him, to share the film with him, to give him the opportunity to stand before an audience as an exonerated person has really been a blessing.
He's a hospital administrator now.
He is. He's a hospital administrator. He has four daughters. He's doing wonderfully. And he really enjoys speaking to young people and educating people about his experience.
Of course, that Central Park jogger case was our Scottsboro boys. It was really, or the Sleepy Lagoon case in Los Angeles in the 1940s. It was I'd say 99% of the people in the city, including myself, because I sat through that trial and I heard the confessions and I was convinced they were guilty as well. To find out later on what had happened and how prosecutors had totally failed to really investigate the case properly and was an amazing turnaround, I think. And there are still many people in the city who refuse to believe the injustice that was created that by the prosecutors there. But, you know, listening or watching your father again, you know, he was my attorney at one time also in 1969. He defended me as a group of Columbia students who were on trial for contempt of court, did a passionate defense in the trial. He lost the case and we all ended up spending 30 days in jail as a result. But we always, it was worth it just to be able to see him in a courtroom and the respect that the judges showed to him, not merely the those who attended, but the judges themselves knew they were before a legendary figure, and they treated him with a deference and a respect that they wouldn't give to a normal criminal defense attorney or political lawyer. And so he really was one of the towering figures in the American criminal defense in this country.
I wanted to go now to another excerpt of your film, William Kunstler, Disturbing the Universe, the documentary featuring archival footage of the two of you, Emily and Sarah Kunstler, confronting your father on live TV about his work.
I had always defended my father to the kids at school. This time, I couldn't find the words. But Sarah confronted him on local television.
I was kind of wondering if ever you decided to take a case and then later, you know, did a double take and said, well, you know, I shouldn't be doing this. This isn't something that in my heart I believe is right.
There have been a few times where I would want to get out of a particular case. That's true. But on the other hand, I always had the feeling that once you're in it, that you shouldn't leave it unless something climactic.
He never gave us a straight answer. And I decided I was never going to be like my father.
Well, I don't want to be a lawyer. Me neither.
Well, if you're both committed to change, at least this point, committed to changing things, if you're not lawyers, what do you think is the best vehicle to do that, to carry that out?
Well, some people act and some people defend them, and maybe we're just people of action.
Okay, there you are saying you both don't want to be a lawyer, but there you are, Sarah, you're a lawyer.
I know, and it was committed to tape, and now I'm sharing it with the world, so I have to deal with it.
I think that's the power of the film is the honesty in it, every which way. I mean, you're critical of your father, and you talk to people who were critical of him, and you talk to the people who worked alongside him, and feel without your father, so many of these cases would not have gotten attention.
Yeah, well, there's no question that this is a film made with love and that this is, in a sense, a love letter to our father, but it's also a critical inquiry. We didn't want to make a puff piece. We wanted to look at him honestly and seriously and come to terms with his life.
We have a last shot that we want to play. That's for viewers and listeners, sound on tape. Asking about your father representing AIM, the American Indian Movement, this excerpt features interviews with singer and activist Harry Belafonte and AIM leader Clyde Bellecourt.
We're going to put the government on trial, he said. It's not the Indian people that are on trial, it's the government. He said, they're the ones that we're after. They're the ones that are going to be found guilty. He prophesied that.
when Bill asked me to come, he had extended the invitation at the same time to a colleague of mine, Marlon Brando. When we met before going into the court, he says, we have arranged seats where you'll be sitting directly behind Dennis Banks and Russell Means, and make sure that the jury gets full awareness of the fact that you really like these guys and admire them, and you're there to support them. And I said to Bill that I said, but Bill, if you're asking us to sit there and to do that, to influence the jury, isn't that jury tampering? He said, everything is jury tampering that goes on in a courtroom.
Harry Belafonte, how has this making of the film changed you, Emily and Sarah?
Well, you know, it really brought our father back to life in a lot of ways for us. When he passed away, we were teenagers, so we never had that opportunity. It also, you know, we realized somewhere along the way that our search for consistency, looking for the black and whites, trying to find, you know, some sort of clear answer was inherently flawed, and that, you know, it is our inconsistent moments that brings about change and that makes us human. So we certainly learned that along the way.
Well, we want to thank you both for being with us. Emily and Sarah Kunstler, good luck on your film coming out. It's going to show in New York Cinema Village, and then it's traveling around the country. And I encourage people to check our website at democracynow.org as we go on our Breaking the Sound Barrier tour, be in San Francisco on Saturday. Then I'm headed to Fort Bragg and Santa Rosa and Corte Madera, and moving on to Berkeley and San Francisco, Palo Alto, going through Oregon and Washington State, then to Washington, D.C. and Philadelphia. We'll be broadcasting from all these places. You can check out our website for the tour dates at democracynow.org. I'm Amy Goodman with Juan Gonzalez. Thanks for joining us.